morning students. Hope you are doing well in your studies. Today I want to enter a new topic, that is third unit. Up to now we finished first, second, ninth chapters. Now third chapter, that is demand analysis. See, in the demand analysis today we have to learn demand. What is demand, its meaning and types of demands, determinants of demands, and also in that which influences, which factors are influences on demand, that also we will learn later classes. And in this we have types of demand, and also demand schedule, demand function, exemptions of demand. We have many things in this lesson. First, today we have to learn clearly about demand. What is demand? See here, demand means desire, means want. That is synonym for this word. But not only that, in economics it is different. Children, usually demand means desire. Usually that is the meaning. But in economics something different between demand and desire. Desire means only want. Demand is something different. What is the meaning? Be absolute. Demand means that the consumer is willing and able to purchase the commodity which he desires. Here commodity, good, nothing but any one thing. You are saying in economics commodity. Okay. Here saying, see, demand having three qualities, two qualities mainly. Willing, able to purchase, desire. I have desire to purchase, I have desire, I have willing to buy that. But I have able to purchase, then only that is called demand. For example, a poor man, he wants to fly in the air, Hyderabad to Bangalore. What he can say? What he can do? He is poor. He has desire to travel by air, Hyderabad to Bangalore. So he wants to travel. That willing, he has willing, he has desire. But here, see, he is poor. He is not ready to able the purchasing of the ticket. Hence, this is not a demand. What is demand? If he is a rich person, he able to purchase the ticket of Hyderabad to Bangalore, then he easily travel by air. So here he has a desire, and also he able to purchase the ticket. So this is called demand, but this is not called demand. Here mainly we are giving one symbol of demand, B, capital B. Students, another example for demand is, see, I listen banana seller's voice and I want to purchase. I have desire to purchase that bananas. But banana seller asking me money. In my hands I have no money to buy bananas. I have desire means want. I have want. I'm willing to take that bananas. But I have no money. I have no money to purchase bananas. See here, desire, not only desire and also willing to pay money is important for demand. Then only we call demand. I have money means able to buy bananas, and I have willing also. That is also demand. If I have able to is also not a demand. See, demand compulsorily having two things. One is willing and second thing is able to purchase. Willing means here desire or want. I have want and also I have able to purchase. Then only that is known as demand. If not, here any one thing is less, that is not demand. Students, demand has some features. Desire for the commodity. Second thing, ability to purchase the commodity. Willingness to pay the price of the commodity. The demand is always at a price. The demand is always per unit of time. For example, per day, per week, per month, per year. That demand has a time period. Students, till now you understood very well what is the meaning of demand and what are its features.
Thank you, children.